My name is Clay Hoover. My presentation is on the filter wash station with both valves open. My teammates are Chris Burns, Chris Jenkins, and Eric Schneider. Outline, I'm going to give you an introduction to background, SSOC, step response experimental, step response model, sign response experimental, sign response model, and conclusions. This is our filter wash station. The flow transmitter sends a signal to the flow controller, and then it sends a signal to the flow control valve. And the difference between ours and theirs is we have the valves. This is the simple schematic input output of our system. The SSOC operating range for ours is 50 to 67%, 67 to 84. 84 to 100. This is a linear 14 when we evaluate our sign response. This is just a graph of the steady state, 100%. Our maximum flow rate with the valves open is 17 pounds per minute. Previous work, step response, 50% input. Our dead time was 0.3 seconds. Our tau was 0.6 seconds. Delta C was 1.3 pounds per minute, delta M was 12%, and gain was 1.1 pounds per minute per percent. Previous work, it's our model equation. Our parameters are K, 0.1 pounds per minute, A is 12.5, if you're M2, your dead time is 0.15 seconds, and your T naught is 0.3 seconds. Those are our averages. This is our model versus experimental. As you see, in the blue is our output of the model of the experimental data, and the pink line is the model output, and they're pretty much right in line with each other. And the turquoise line is the experimental versus model. This is a comparison between the two. For the model, we had 0.1 pound minutes per snoop. Experimental was 0.11. Tau is 0.32, and then it's 0.61 for experimental. Tau is 0.94 and 0.59. T naught is 0.32 and 0.61. Assign input parameters. Delta C, change in output. Delta M, change in input. Amplitude ratio is delta C over delta M. T is the lag time. Equivalency, capital T is the period. And PA is the phase angle. Equivalent to over big T times 360. Sign input graph. You can see equivalent T is the distance between the peaks. Delta C, big T, delta M. Voting parameters, ARU, is your ultimate amplitude ratio. KCU, ultimate controller gain. FU, ultimate frequency. A system D. Here's our Bode graph. As you can see, ultimate frequency is 0.7 seconds. Our 1 over KCU is 0.012 seconds. The linear portion is the order. You can see it there. And K is 0.15. This is our Bode model. From 50 to 67%, you can see that it fits the data pretty well. Bode model, frequency versus phase angle, from 50 to 67%. Looks like an outlier there. Values for K, KCU, FU, ULT, and tau from Bode plots analysis. This is a comparison of our three ranges that we work with. The order varies from 1 to 3.42. K, gain varies from 0.11 to 0.15. KCU varies from 20 to 25.6. Ultimate frequency varies from 0.49 to 0.68. Lowercase T varies from 0.64 to 0.85. T naught varies from 0.43 to 0.65. values for KAT and TNOT from the modeling. Pretty similar results, 0.11, 0.15, 0.57, 0.6, 0.55, 0.91. TNOT's a little higher. Results? Is there results? This is a comparison between your model and experimental. The two ranges, they're pretty similar for the first group and the third one. For K. Here's a comparison for tau. They vary a little bit more here. Looks like the model is a little bit lower than your experimental. It has higher tau for all three ranges. T-naught comparison. It looks like the model is higher than the experimental for all three. It's a lot off, 50 to 67. And conclusions, the model fits the experimental data.